Bye.
Bye.
going to the front ramp. Yeah, these are waiting, the vehicle being sprayed. And these other parts, the bolt-on goodies, they'll be waiting there for when they come in, you know, they'll set one. So just put them still on there. This is in paint, but that one on the corner of paint. This is an undercoat here. But they get, it's 12 coats of paint they get to receive after the undercoat, you know. Which is, it used to be a lot more, but the grade of paint is a lot better now than what we used to get. We say before you used to have to put loads and loads of paint, maybe 20 coats of paint, and then work it back, because the quality of the paint wasn't particularly good. But we've got good paint now, so we can do less coats. And of course, another thing, we've got this electroplating process that stops rust. So you're not worried about cutting down on the coats of paint, you know. If a guy specifies that I want 8 of an inch of paint on my vehicle, man can have it. He can have anything that Aston Martin he wants. If he's prepared to pay the price, which is way do we do. Obviously, you can go on slow wheels and then be pushed off and actually go out into one of these lanes. We come around the front, bottom of each either. Yeah. Then they have 14 inch discs on the front. Getting these guys by and the management telling you. So you've got to have plenty of stopping power. So what they've done there...
That is the double supercharger.
The gearbox, unfortunately, is somebody else's. A 6-speed gearbox. You can just stay there, that's it. 6-speed gearbox. Some are manual, some are automatic. It seems such a waste of a lovely engine to have an automatic.
That's on the dyno.
But that's the engine.
What they do about it? Other
cash valves
or?
Yeah. You could tune that up. I think the nearest they got it up to was about 570 brake horsepower.
Cool. What do you reckon? 700?
Yeah, obviously there's a certain amount of security. Just you appreciate there's a lot of people coming around from the you'll see the finished product. From a foundry, we don't cast our own. This actually comes from a foundry, and the heads now are supplied to us by Cosworth. They've got a very good foundry.
Cosworth.
But this is the only reason you'll see it. The difference is this is a standard cylinder here because it's got round forks. The Vantage, Super Go Fast, has got oval forks. Got oval forks because of the gas flowing and things like that. We make our own comp down the bottom on the prime in the second layer and come up here. They go away to the other department and they're weighed up within grams. Very accurate. From that. And this machine behind us, this machine costs £750,000. That goes on that machine and comes off with the bores finished. The only thing he doesn't do, he doesn't finish the bore with the crankshaft. That's done on that little machine there. The only difference is the fact that it's got, this is a standard because it's round. That's just finished off of that machine. It will do the two heads and the cylinder block.
They're applied to ball bearings?
This, you know, the valve seats, chassis boards. So they'll match all up, you know, the eight ones. Cylinder blocks and cylinder heads come from this area.
The bulb attacks?
Well, security, yeah. I mean, say, like everything else, you must be covered. All the companies must be covered.
Ford Pete, you
come in. This way, boys, sir. Okay. So this is the engine as it's actually come from that department next door after the manufacture. And this is the way the guy set it up on his stand here to start working it. And he'll go away and work his heads all the way through the field, all the way through the balance, and all the way through engine. This facility is across the road, but unfortunately, you can't go in there.
Don't go back tomorrow.
Where are we going to go this way?
But you only hired it, right?
Yes. Brilliant. I'm alright, you're saying there's only five gaskets on a bit on an engine now. How many was there?
Four
is there?
Five, you're right.
Five? We've got the moment we've got a guy in here who's actually helping them build up cylinder heads. So all the parts will be laid out, it'll be washed, it'll be all cleaned up, it'll be all fettled. We actually do our own cam boring as well. We've actually got our own cam boring machine to bore our own cam bores. We make our own cam caps, bearing caps. Let me say, apart from cam shafts and pistons, let me say the rest of the stuff we mostly make ourselves, you know. But this will be assembled. It's ready there. He'll assemble it and then he'll pass it on to one of these engine builder guys. But it's only because the guy, you know, is in the department. You never saw any ladies on the other side of the factory.
No.
But I mean, so you know, when all who are the best seamstresses and the best work with stitching is ladies, you know.
Yeah.
And the ladies have been here years and they're, you know, experts, you know. And the other guys, the majority of them do
frames
and the seats and things like that. Yeah. This guy here.
Yeah.
Even this is quite a big department, really. It's been uprated. They do.